So we are starting with a very broad outline structure of what is course all about, is aligned to, and what all we are going to learn, what all you are going to take with you as after completion of the training, how are the job, your roles, what are your roles and responsibility if you are a technical consultant or a functional consultant. And then we'll brief you about what high-paying financial management and how it is different than other ERP solution. And the market has flooded with many ERP solution. Especially there are many market leading tool log called SAP or similar category, but still high-paying financial management stand, and it has 2000 base customers. So what's the reason behind this? Some of the important question which HFM can address, some business problem HFM can address. Let me start with the outline what course is all about. Basically, this course consists of four modules. The four modules are clubbed together in order to see, I see the requirement of accordingly will customize our course. We start with, I'll be sharing across data warehousing fundamental videos. Although it is not required, it's an added knowledge. There would be two videos, so you would be knowing some basic terminology we use called dimension and facts. It could be a recorded session, additional learning. This for technical users. For functional user can also view it. For a technical user, if you are new to accounting principle, we are going to share across six video tutorials what all you should be knowing as a part of which you should be knowing before you start HFM, because HFM is more functional than technical. So actual business users are functional users, financial users. So you, the technical user, should be understanding basic terminologies before they get into the training. So I'll be sharing across a recorded video. We procure the license for these videos from the University of Illinois, and then this is all prerequisite, and then we start with high-paying financial management. There will be close to 22 classes for HFM, and we'll be working on high-paying 11.1.1.13. Also we'll work on 11.1.2 because I want to address existing project as well as new project which is coming into the market. So you should be prepared to work on existing project as well as if there are new requirements coming which is into new environments. So we'll work on both, and we also work on migration part. Specifically, there are 30% of the project in the industries are migration projects if you are technical users. We'll also focus on migration of HFM application. That's one thing. Then we'll have a FDQM. This is specialized data quality and consistency tool. Data quality check. Confidence on number is a key factor for HFM. That's one of the important aspects we always focus on. Data quality, financial data quality, and data quality and consistency check. This is primarily for functional users. Although expertise in order to write scripting and all, technical users also require. So if I say 60% job is done by functional user and 40% are technical, right? The overall purpose of building HFM is to enable business users on functional user to execute their task on their own without using any technical support. So the complete HFM in design considering the requirement in mind. This is the reason 60% of the job requirement, 60 to 70% of the job requirement in US as well as in India, they prefer the formally educated people in, you know, finance domain, or people experienced with 10 year plus experience in finance. Most of the job opening for them, at the end of the day they work. So FDQM would have close to 10 sessions, 10 classes, but logically it would be 15 sessions. And logically it means in one class we'll cover two sessions, you know, somehow to cope up, to wind up the session in a month. Then in HFM, then we have a financial reporting. Naturally, if you do financial closing, consolidation reporting is required. You know, you create a various reporting of balance sheet, for profit and loss statement, intercompany transaction report, minority interest in report. Many reports you need to create, very compliant. So we'll create a HFM In financial reporting, we create statutory reporting, and we also create management reporting, internal reporting we call it. So all the report which you create in order to satisfy the various compliance, we create in financial reporting tool. So there would be close to 3 sessions for the same, 2 to 3 session. Maybe if we conduct in weekend, we'll combine 2 session to 1 session. Then we have a smart view, is a very small component, a part of HFM also, only you can understand. They specialize for management reporting. So their job requirements are flashed. They explicitly say we need people who know how to write management reporting, statutory reporting, various kind of other reporting, ad hoc reporting. So smart view is another small component where you learn how to create a management reporting. And this is Oracle Data Integrator, is for more for technical user, where we show you how to integrate your high-end financial management with legacy applications. Suppose you're pulling data from PeopleSoft, Oracle, eBusiness Suite, SAP, how ODI can be used to pull the metadata from different sources. This is another requirement, another new hot, most required technology in the industry. People expecting someone should be knowing ODI along with HIPN. So HIPN is the primary skill, ODI is going to be secondary skill. So we're going to have a 3 session on the same. We'll concentrate on integration part. But all you need to be a HFM consultant. So this is all is clubbed together into a common training. Okay, what we'll be taking some business cases and see how to execute them. Right from capturing the metadata requirement from business, loading this requirement to HFM, doing closing consolidation, and finally reporting. So I'll be providing this material, all the POCs I worked in the past, some project, except the confidential and material which property to the organization. So I'll be giving you a student guide. Student guide is like more theory. It will given all the aspects, functional aspect, technical aspects of HFM. Then we'll talk about lab guide. Lab guide will be completely technical. Whatever I do in the classroom, I'll share across the same thing plus additional exercises it has. I'll give you practice application. Couple of application we worked in the past for POC. One of the project I worked fair enough. You would have a fair enough idea about how the kick start, how the project is being started in HFM application. It's an end-to-end implementation. It's hardly you get a chance to work on an end-to-end implementation project. Most of the time you get a one component, enhancement, maintenance, you know, support kind of project. But a kind of proof of concept gives you the starting point of the project, where you see how to capture metadata requirement, capturing business requirement, designing functional design documentation, business requirement documentation, mapping functional design document with, you know, high level documentation, low level, all this documentation stuff, more you know, it's like a functional job, you know how to do that. That we'll see in a practice application. I'll share the, you know, organization called HFM raw metadata. Raw metadata, it means when you pull metadata from different disparate sources, how it look like, and then convert it into common metadata model. Now the one practice which we followed, more than close than 4 projects we implemented, and the common set of problem we face iteratively, which causes our project delay, loss, and so many other things, you know. So we came up with a common data model, which we prepared completely, my team, and we decided to whatever data source we work on, whichever line of business you're working on, it will land up into a common model. So there's a common model and practice we prepare. I'll share across the same thing. Although we had a lot of, you know, data model, a lot of money spent in order to build this model. So whichever environment you work, but this can be a centralized model, can be used as one centralized model to build your HFM application, which extensively will save your metadata building at least by 20%, especially if you're architect, data modeler architect, or you are already functional concept at high level, it would add a great help to you. Common questionnaires, when I get into a project, what is the first question I ask to the business? What all I should have? What are my weapons, you know, if I get into battle? So my weapons are, I should have some list of questionnaires, what information you should receive from the business, which consists of your raw metadata, which consists of your existing reports, transactional reports, report templates, and your own reporting model. So all this information we have to have in your hand. The one challenge you are definitely going to face is your business user resists to give you information. They assume that, you know, if you take the information, you build up some solution, and as a result of this, they might lose their job. So extracting this information is very important. There are some non-technical aspects which ensure your project success. Okay, so if you are appearing for certification, we'll also help you in HFM certification. Questions I give you, preparation is in your hand. So by doing a certification, you can say, jump into market, say you are formally trained and certified into HFM. So the overall idea is to equip you to get a project, jump into the market, place yourself in a job. That's it. That's all material we are going to share across. Now I'm going to talk about what is HFM and what is the functional aspects of it. We'll see the brief history about HFM, what is that, and compare when there are many two in the market. Primary, people ask me, we already have a SAP, why should we go for HFM? I'm pretty happy with my ERP suite, why should I go for HFM? There are a couple of questions we need to ask, I mean, you need to answer to the client. So let's talk about this. What is HFM? Basically, it's a financial closing consolidation tool. If you have any other purpose, don't go for HFM. HFM is primarily designed for financial closing and consolidation. Again, the question, what's the big deal in it, right? Many tools can do that. You can buy $100. You can buy a simple financial consolidation tool in $100 also. Again, does the same thing. HFM is not designed for departmental and for particular line of business. It's an enterprise level solution. It's one of the component from complete enterprise based solution. That's the beauty of it. Okay, so first we'll see what is financial closing consolidation. All of you three are functional guys, so I don't need to tell you all these stupid things. You do it day by day.